let's get started with the trim. Most of this is just pull off. You might want to watch this piece. Look at these clips.
Right here.
Yes, it sounds like you're destroying it. Good. I believe it's 4 T25s. And then a series of clips. Hold the big panel on. You can pop these off. The only reason I'm taking this off is the harness that connects the inners. I don't believe is long enough to go all the way around. It needs to go across. Should be this one. Yeah, negative, not long enough, so it's got to come across. One, two, three, four. So this is the same clips. Just be aware of these sections here. They wrap around up in here. So even once it's loose, it's still there. See this section? These wrap around, make it a little bit difficult to peel it out. So just verify that you didn't leave any clips behind in the sheet metal. trim down. Looks like I left one.
Yep.
Needle nose pliers, typically. Just give it a little squeeze. If you compress it too much, you may have to pull it back open a bit. They just slide in. So I couldn't find my fish tape, so I got a piece of a string trimmer cord for my weed eater, and I hit it with a lighter to smooth the tip of it down a bit, and I'm just going to try to fish it up through here. So that went straight through, and I'm not sure, there's quite a bit of slack from the harness that J-Bell put together, so I may pull both rungs up through the right side boot and up and over, assuming I have enough slack. Because this hole is much smaller and we've got a plug interface here. So, I don't know, we'll see when I get there. So I'm gonna stage the run that connects the inners. I'm gonna take advantage of some of the existing clips. Couple zip ties where I need to. Obviously, we've got a little bit of slack that easily taken out with a small loop or something.
So the plugs, pretty simple. You can use a screwdriver, a pry tool, but your fingernail, if you can get it, pop that clip out. Then you can depress, and that's it. So these are going to tie together, but we're going to wait because we have some pins that need to be seated in these connectors properly. So I'm not going to finalize this connection just yet. And this one, of course, is the mirror image. And then these are two bolts that are going to be securing this inner light. I believe those are 8mm. You may need a deep well socket to clear that. And, as you can see, I did the wiper delete. So I'm still working on putting up a video, some video I took on that, but it's holding up great. So I pulled this out a little bit, and I put a light inside of here, and there's actually quite a bit of room. Incidentally, this clip right there released, so I'm going to need to just give it a little push to reseat that clip, but I'm trying to get this to focus down there. There's a pretty big gap that brings it down in here, big enough to where I might actually be able to simply lower this down so I don't have to try to pull this end up from the bottom. I may not need to fish anything down there at all, so we're gonna try that first. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can't just lower this down. And the opening is close to the end. So success. Yeah, it wasn't so bad. So this is the section that's gonna run up through and connect to the inner assembly plug harness. So this will be fed up through the top, so I'm going to leave that there. And
Gonna get to work over here on this side. Get the camera staged up real quick. Try the same thing over here. And this just, you just gently pull on this and it'll pull itself out from behind this seal. Sure your D for driver side, DO, driver side outer on the label. Hopefully this will have enough. Ideally, hoping this will have enough slack now to come up through this side. I think so. I left a little bit of slack when I tested that, so I think we'll be good to run both sides up the passenger side boot here. Okay, so I've got some of this fabric tape, Tessa brand. I believe it's what the OEM wraps most of their harness with. So, what I'm going to try to do, without making too much of a mess, is tape these up, take this all together, gently pull it through. Hopefully this tape won't leave too much residue on the wiring, but these would surely get caught being pulled through here. So I'm not even gonna bother taking that chance. Actually, I might take some of my nitrile gloves, maybe cut the fingertips off. All inside of one of these little mitts. Doesn't go all the way down, but I've cut a couple lengths of tape here. Yeah, that'll work better. prep the other side same way, then I'll attach both of them. Thick in any one spot. I could even fully stagger them like that. And yeah, there's not a whole lot of extra space inside of here. I think it'll be safer to stagger them a bit more. It'll take a little bit longer to prepare, but system down. Get this a little bit closer. Let's give it a shot and see if bring the camera in a little bit over. Going underneath the looms, the existing looms, I'm going underneath them, so I'm gonna give that a try. Definitely stuffed. I'm not sure. I know there's a lot of extra bulk with the tape and everything, so hopefully I can get it through without any damage. Otherwise, I might have to fish one up through the driver's side here. I'm not gonna pull on it too hard before I pull back. It's moving, but I'm definitely applying some pressure. Some force pulling on it. This a little bit. Obviously you want to be careful you don't pull the actual crimped connectors off the end of the wire. So double check that prior to terminating them in the connectors. All right, it's easing up a little bit. There we go. Now it's freed up. There we go. Much, much nicer. Okay, success on the wire pull. Let's get this last one. Cleaned up. Good. String trimmer cord out of the way. Tape. Still pretty tight. Let me come in a little bit closer. So we have a little bit of slack. Just enough to tuck. Actually, I might need a little bit more. I want to be sure I clear these clips. Trim back on, so I don't have to worry about that falling out. Already got in the way. Push this back in. up. Stage it up. Zip ties. I guess you could kind of weave it in and out of some of this stuff, but I'm gonna leave it loose for now in case I need to push some slack back inside of here. If I have room to wrap it here. Probably going overboard on the zip ties, but this one separates and there's another notch right there. Sweet. Yes. Perfect. So yes, if you want to run the driver's side up the passenger side boot, it appears to be perfect length. This one is going to be way too long, so we can choose to put some slack back inside of here, do a wrap here, kind of like the idea of just pushing some back in here. Sorry for the noise. Aw, oh, man. It's pretty hot in my garage, so I got a small fan. Blow it on there. Be careful here. Let's solder it onto the glass. It's either the defroster or the antenna. Clean this up too. Okay, so we're pretty much staged up to terminate these pins per the instructions provided, and
the outers require nothing more than just connect to the existing harness and the new taillight. Obviously, we've got to get the light assembly swapped out, but this is clean on the outers, ready to go. No trim removal. Already took care of this one piece here that we took out. Since this is pretty much done, I think I'll go ahead and get the actual outer housings swapped out and get that going. So we're on the passenger side outer in the hatch. And aside from the connector, this is the only thing holding the assembly in. These are pretty tight. You basically just break this loose and just like anything else, just unscrew it. It's a little bit tough on the fingers. Tug gently. There's not much slack. So. So just pull this clip, red clip, back, and then depress the black. That's it. So then the new harness. Let's see if this reach out here. Yeah, so we're just gonna plug in. See if I can get set up here real quick. So we're just gonna plug in the factory. Connector, so that auto locks when I pushed in on it, and this will connect to the new taillight. So we'll get that back out. That's that clip, so it'll lock in, and then you'll seat this clip. Got some standing water in there. It was pouring earlier. That's it. Let's get that plugged up. And so here's my passenger outer. Lock done. So, oops. You gotta watch this. This right here. There's a small plastic assembly attached to the bumper. So you want to make sure you watch out for this piece that will seat in there properly. You don't want to have to force it. It'll go in and line up all the way around the perimeter. And if it's not, it's probably because of this. Tuck the wire in. So I figured out what these are for. So this is the other side.
These are basically adjustment screws to change the height that the light sits, or the depth in and out, or at an angle that it sets. It's a T15, so you go through the hole and maybe test with one out. So let's see. See, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring them out. Feels like they stop. They don't move. Well, they move quite a bit, but yeah, it automatically stops when you back it out. You can feel a definite stopping point. But there's still a considerable amount of adjustability there. So I'm gonna bring them out gently until they stop, and then based on how tight this guy was in the housing, I'm hoping that'll pull, because I'm pretty confident this is seated properly. It's just, this is gonna really pull this thing in, so I'm gonna make sure these adjustment screws are out or backed in as far as they can go, so the light seats fully, and then I'll make some fine adjustments. I need to wait till the inners are on and the hatch is shut, and then take note of whether or not the outer protrudes out further than the inner, or vice versa, and make some final adjustments there. I'm gonna unplug this just to make sure. That way I'm not risking banging it around in my car either. See the circumference of the shaft of the driver is very tight in this hole, so that might throw you off a bit thinking that you're getting in there, but you're not actually, when it's the driver's diameter that's a bit big for here. Plus they're plastic, so you don't want to strip the head there. I'm gonna start working on this, get this started. Keep in mind it is appears to be nylon, it's plastic, and I believe this threaded portion is a steel insert, so, and it catches almost right away against that spring unless you're really pushing hard on the light assembly. I'm leaning up against it with my body to hold it. But yeah, it bites with spring tension right away, so it, but hopefully the first couple threads you can tell you're not cross-threading it. So I must have overlooked that that is actually a hex head. It's not, the flash is kind of washing it out on the camera. There you go. It's 10 millimeter, and you can just get a small quarter inch drive in here. You just, you can push against this material here, and this will probably help you get started getting the mount back in, because it's tough on my fingertips trying to get in there and twist that. I've turned it down a bit, so I think it's pretty much just about bottom now. I'm gonna back it off to get a better feel for how well it's really locking down. Let's see if I can feel it with my hand. I'm not applying any pressure to the outside of the housing currently. Yeah, I can feel it get really tight. I don't want to go too tight. I don't want to break it. It is, after all, plastic. From the outside. Put my weight on it and see how it feels. And it still feels really solid. Let me try to back it off again. Yeah, I can back it off. Yeah, it feels like it's stopping. I don't want to go any further. Let's see what it looks like. Seated. Light. Seated quite well. There's. And I haven't touched these yet since I backed them in all the way, so. I'm going to turn those until I feel them apply pressure and leave it at that for now. So I got the passenger one done, driver's side. Just seated it and tightened the nylon screw. I'm going to go ahead and back these out now just to put some pressure on it. Kind of see it if you watch, but see the light housing moving in and out. That's the effect you get. What I'm trying to do is close the gap out here on the fender side. There's a little bit of a gap, just very, very small amount. So by bringing this out, it somewhat rotates on its axis from where it's bolted in a little bit. Very small gap along there. Okay, so on the hatch,
You've got some wiring to do on both sides, on the inners. Give you a couple of just quick examples as I go through the side. The instructions that come with it, it's pretty straightforward. So, first thing we have to do is, this is the stock plug that was in the original OE taillight. We need to unlock this portion. You can see this one is already unlocked. So we need to pry that open. It's not too difficult, really. I use just a really small flathead. I'm trying not to stab myself in my hand. Too far, probably break off. And there's only one wire that's going to go in the original stock plug. So we're looking for P3, which is the longest one here, the black wire. And there's, of course, the instructions have a there's a diagram that you're going to follow. It's pretty clear, but I figured I'd go through one side just to give you an example. You need to watch the direction of the pin. It can go in 180 degrees out, but you need to make sure you verify the direction of the slot, or it's not going to lock in properly. And the diagram is from looking at the plug from the side that the wires enter, at least with J-Bale's harness. So I already know where this one goes. You can hear it click, you can feel it seat. This is the only action on this plug, so we're going to lock it back down. That's the original plug for the original tail. That's complete. Now we've got to terminate these last three and these two plugs from J-Bale's harness. So next up we've got P1, position one. So I know this one is gonna go in here. You can feel it lock, you can probably hear it click, and that's the only action on this plug. So and these last two are both going to be seating in this final on the passenger side. It's blue, it's green on the driver's side. So then I'm going to go with P4, diagram again from this view. It's gonna be
this position here. It's locked in. And P8 is our final. Connect the harness, seat the clip, and this will seat into the new taillight, which I have not pulled this one out and replaced it yet, so we'll get to that in a second. So if you've done any research, there is one plug that does have to be modified out of the whole bunch, and that is the original OEM connector that was originally seated in the original taillight. This one I've already replaced. Essentially, you're going to be cutting off this ridge right there to allow it to seat into this receptacle. I was going to use a Dremel with a little sanding wheel, but I'm going to try to cut it first because I really don't want to make a mess and get the potential dust from the plastic blown into the back of my car. So I'm gonna give it a shot with the blade first and see. See if I can push through it again without stabbing myself. Yeah, it's pretty dense. Might need to go with an X-Acto blade and just shave it. Yeah. The Dremel might be easier. Take it off really quickly. Hit it with a Dremel real quick. See what happens. I think I made too much of a mess. Don't see a lot of dust. Yeah, try to clean this up a bit. Take a little bit more off. Let's just see if it'll plug in first. Nice. Alright. So, this side is complete. I've already changed the tail. It's going to be a matter of just securing the rest of this wiring. I don't want this plastic clip vibrating once I reinstall the trim. So, I'm going to try to tighten this up a bit. Maybe some zip ties, bringing it up tight. Keep it up in there before I replace this trim. Let's get this tail light out real quick. It's pretty straightforward. There's 2 8mm. This last light seated. Notice the light matches the plug, the color, and the driver's side is green on both sides. So I'm going to be pushing the light fixture, obviously, down, but towards the top and inside of the hatch. There's these little small stoppers on the perimeter of the light, and it seemed to work out well on the driver's side, the way it lined up in the hatch. So I'm going to apply that movement prior to snugging those nuts up. You can pretty much seat those almost entirely by hand.
I'm gonna follow up though. Let's see. And then obviously I'm going to bring this around and probably zip tie it up, just tidy it up a bit, make sure it clears. Again, I don't want it rattling around in the plastic trim. See how it looks. Sorry for the fan. And then the two hidden screws that were behind here that lift these sections up a bit, I used them to line up these faces. So you can see, I made a small adjustment, and the inner protrudes out from the outer very, very slightly. But to be honest, if you check your stock lights, they're not spot on either. Very, very small difference there. But the gap is pretty, it is nice and even. The line around the assembly, all the way around the hatch. This light is washing me out. So basically, I've got some trim to reinstall, and then I'm going to do the coating with my BCDS. Not much, a few things to change. And I may make a small adjustment here. Nice and even with the body line. I'll do some fine tuning here, possibly. But actually this one is, sorry, the light's glaring. Might have to get some additional footage of this with some better lighting, but This one actually almost lines up perfectly.
All right, so time to put the trim back in. Got the lights done. I did do the coating. I got the harness nicely tucked up. I've zip tied these plugs up fairly tight. And hopefully this area won't contact anything. I don't believe it will. But we'll be able to see when the cutout's removed. So this is a bit tricky because this wraps fairly tightly around these sections. So you've got to manipulate this piece just a bit to get it in. It's no big deal unless you've got tent, so you got to worry about possibly cutting into your tent with a sharp edge of this plastic. So let's get started. I like to bring it in from the side. It's going to be way up here actually. I can immediately see one of the clips right there. I'm going to seat it. And this is another clip right here I can see. Nice. Get your screws here, but plastic pegs on these corners too. So you want to make sure these plastic pegs line up with the holes, otherwise you'll likely snap them off. I think I was hung up on something a little bit. You noticed it suddenly shifted into its seat. Trim pieces. So these have these hooks. Make sure you get them hooked in there. portion here is a bit tricky. So you've got these sections.
Let's see, it's okay. But you'll want to get seated properly.
To
this portion right here. Sorry, I'm trying to. There you go. Trying to seat that's a little bit difficult.
I move the camera a bit.
I'm gonna drop this side in. Driver's side. These are a little bit challenging. Three distinct clips locking in, and then I'm fully seated up here. These kind of lock in together, and then once you get it in, you should be able to give it a little bit of movement. It slides and the clip tracks just a bit. Nice. So and you'll see. Got plenty of room for the locking covers on both sides. We just gotta finalize this last piece of trim here, so we can get the camera back up. Last piece of trim to apply. And don't forget about those hooks right there. I just got these final four Torx screws. Snap on the panels.
got the trim back in place. And these are these little ears that give people problems on the side here. Wiring all cleaned up. I would suggest, I did use these two that I kind of showed you earlier, the leveling screws, I guess you could call them, but you really need a long shank, maybe a T-handle, something with a long enough arm, because I had an issue whereas the base of the driver was wanting to hang up on the light prior to getting it fully seated, and then you really bind whenever you try to get that extra clearance, so maybe a longer driver. But the lights line up really nicely. All right, check it out.